Hi everyone, my name is Zuhaib, and today is Sunday. It's very hot today these days, and I hope you guys are staying hydrated and staying at home. In my last video, I talked about sequential chains in LangChain, so how we can leverage multiple LLM calls in a series manner. Today I am starting about a new vector database series. In this series, we will be talking about different available vector databases. Pinecone would be the first one we will be talking about. Pinecone is very famous and easy developer friendly and easy to use a vector database. And yeah, if you guys have not subscribed my channel, then subscribe it first. And yeah, with that, let's get it started. So we will be discussing about Pinecone, and I hope you guys have heard this name before. It is very famous vector database, and in this tutorial we will be discussing about its main features that are necessary to be known for using it for our applications. So let's start it. So the first feature is it provides us really good performance. The performance of a vector database can be judged from its throughput. Throughput means like how many queries it is serving as per unit of time. Yeah, and also the performance can be judged with respect to the latency, like how much time it is taking to serve per request. So with respect to these two time-based constraints, Pinecone is very good at them, and also it means it also provides us very good real-time semantic search or vector search as well. So that's why I would recommend to use Pinecone for your vector search operations. So the other thing is the scalability. So whenever your data requirements and data operation requests are becomes really large throughout your application in production, so Pinecone provides you the facility of horizontal scalability and elasticity. So yeah, developer friendly. So Pinecone is very developer friendly, easy to use in multiple languages like Python, JavaScript. It is actually written in C++, so yeah, so it is very developer friendly as well. Cloud native architecture. Pinecone actually uses AWS or GCP services to host all its database or vector indexes and for all of its operations. Therefore, it provides us really good performance, and also really good it is very good at providing you the security measures. Pinecone charges you per pod. We will discuss what pod is, but it charges you as per pod how many pods you use for your application. And yeah, so if you want to know more about pricing, you can visit its website, and you can give different your settings or different requirements that you want to use for your vector database. It provides you instantly what pricing should be. So yeah, so you can visit this website, its website for the pricing needs. So what is pod? Pod is actually a combination of computational resources. So you need to perform different multiple operations for querying your index or updating or maybe deleting these different get and post operations. So for that you need some kind of a hardware architecture. So that hardware and storage requirements are provided you in the form of a pod. And yeah, so it contains CPUs, RAMs and disk, these kind of computational resources. Port selection. Port selection is very important for your application, and you need to consider them related if you want to get good performance. So query throughput. If you want to have a higher throughput, so you can use different P2 ports, because it provides you really higher throughput. These are different types of ports that are available on Pinecone, P1, S1 and P2. Depending upon your application requirement and or vector search requirement, you can use them. Data volume. If you want to store very high number of vectors, like in millions, in 1 million or in millions, then you can use S1 ports, because it provides you very large storage capacity. If you are requirement is to get lower latency, like you want very less time to answer your queries, so you can use P1 ports. So this is our main topic. What is Pinecone index? Actually, if you have already learned about data structures like array data structure or linked list data structure or list data structure in Python, you know the all the information is stored in some structure format. So in vector databases, all the information is stored in the form of an index. It is highest level organizational unit of vector data. So Pinecone, if you talked about Pinecone index structure, then we can see it here. Pinecone actually stores your all your data with respect to different vector IDs. So here is your one vector, and here is your vector ID. It is stored. Every vector is given some kind of a vector ID, and here comes your actual vectors that consist of the numbers. And if you want to store also your metadata along with your vector for efficient querying or semantic search, you can also store along with your vector as well. So this is the way in which your data is being stored on an index. Multiple vectors are being stored. So vector ID, here is vector ID being stored. Then the vector comes at the actual vector. Here is the metadata that you want to retrieve against your query search. So namespace, then the namespace concept is very important, and very we need to discuss it here. So it is a kind of a data organization into different spaces. So sometimes what happens is that store your data into different data sets. Like you can you may store your customer data here, like this can be if you want to store your customer data on a separate space, then you can use namespaces over there. You can name them as customer space. And if you want to store some kind of a other kind of data, like it can be related to your application data, it can be stored on different namespace. Like you can use it as a application namespace. So you can create multiple namespaces depending upon your application and store them inside a one index. So multiple namespaces can be used inside a one index, so that you do not need to create multiple indexes for your one application. So multiple database it supports multiple data sets, also the multi-application support. So if you want to use a multiple if you want to use the same index for multiple applications, you can store their data in different namespaces as well. So Pinecone index operation, Pinecone provides us multiple data related or vector search related operations that you can use. The first one is describe index stats. If you want to count your vectors, that how many vectors are being stored in your index, you can use this operation by giving different input. Like you can count your vectors with respect to the namespace. This fetch data, the fetch data or get request data, if you want to retrieve some vector from your index, then you can use this operation, but you have to give a vector ID that which vector you want to retrieve. Upsort operation, like if you have already created an index and you want to store more vectors inside your index, then you can use upsort operations. Update. So if you have already some vector stored on your index and now you want to update it, then you can use the corresponding ID to update that vector information. Query. So yeah, this is the main operation to for vector databases. Like if you want to do some semantic search or similarity search, you can use this operation. Delete. So if you want to delete some data point or vector, you can give the vector ID and can delete the corresponding vector from your index. So this is all the related links on which you can get more details, but these are all the important features that we need to start with the Pinecone index. So thank you guys very much for listening to me, and in our coming tutorial we will walk through the code how we can see all these things in actual implementation. So till then, bye bye, see you later.